Thank you. Thank you, Ron, so much. We've worked together in a lot of different political organizing and organizational projects. And I'm here representing Left Voice for an International Socialist, Revolutionary Socialist website. And we're also organized as well. And I'm so glad that now socialism is not a bad word. It's a good thing, you know, and we can talk about what that means and what we want to build. But I want to kind of talk about some other solutions in terms of what we can do to fight these cops, these killer cops. Because as Ron said, they keep killing us. We shut down the streets, we shut down the highways, we do all these different things, protesting, marching, and voting, and now we're supposed to vote for a warmonger or a bigot. That's supposed to be our choice, and I say neither of them. I refuse to choose a bigot or a warmonger. I refuse to choose either one of those people. Both of those people are with the interests of the capitalists, the bosses, the wealthy. We need our own political party that has no bosses, no capitalists, and no bigots that are members. Because as long as you have someone who's Chase Morgan and you're in the same organization of them, you will never have any power. They will never be representative of you. So we need to break from those capitalist parties. But I wanted to talk about another kind of idea of a strategy. And it's about where we work. So how many people are working? How many people are employed here, right? How many people are union members? So a few of us. So a few of us are union members. I'm a member of SEIU, Local 721. I'm a case manager. And, you know, we need to kick the cops out of our unions. How dare we have the cops being members of our unions? And the prison guards. It's ridiculous. How can you, on the one hand, have Philando Castile that was murdered by the police, who was a Teamster, and then have the Teamsters represent the police that murdered him? That's not your union brothers and sisters. They're not our union brothers and sisters. They're our enemies. So we need to organize for cops out of our unions, and that's something that we can do. But the other thing that we have, the power that we have as people who are union, non-union, is the power to not work. When they murder us, when they oppress us, we need to stop working. We need to go on strike. And that needs to be something that we think about all the time. Many of us were like, okay, the police murdered somebody. We're about to shut down the freeway. 405, the 10 is done. We're shutting you down. And that's right. We need to continue to do that. And we need to organize ourselves as working class people to shut this down, to take the economy. We control the economy. They don't control it. We're the ones that work. They just make the decisions. We need to take that away from them. And furthermore, we need to organize along gender, race, class, gender lines. You know, trans people are being murdered as well. LGBT people are being murdered as well. That is not a separate issue from black people being murdered, because black people are queer too. Black people are trans too. And we are going to stand up for women. Everybody who gets murdered by the cops, and we're going to defend them. And the cops, they're not our friends. I want to say another thing about the police that were killed. So, you know, a lot of other organizations have been intimidated and say you have to take a stand and call for it to be a tragedy and things like that. But I want to say this. Over 600 people have already been murdered by the police around the country. And where was their outrage for that? Where's the congressional sin? What happened? Why aren't y'all sitting in? Where is it? Because that was a photo opportunity. That was stunting. They weren't trying to stand up for our rights. And Obama spoke out, it's a tragedy about what happened to the police. They're going to fly the flags half-staff. Didn't do that for Alton Sterling. Didn't do that for any of those people. Hasn't done that for Rekia Boyd. None of those people. So they don't stand for us. They're against us. And one other thing I want to say before I give up the mic is about internationalism. This government that we don't control, right? Because the superdelegates elected the primary, and now the Electoral College is going to do it. So really, we don't vote. We actually don't vote for that. We're the popular vote. But this government that we don't vote for is the cop of the world. They are the cops of the world. Everybody else is terrified of them. When people speak out and say something in Mexico, you know what they do? They send paramilitary groups, they bribe the government down there, and they murder those people. And that's what they're doing in Oaxaca as well. And we can stand in solidarity with them too. All of the teachers struggle along with all their struggles. So we need to not only organize against the brutality and oppression and exploitation that we face in this racist, imperialist, and white supremacist capitalist system, but we also need to fight internationally and stand in solidarity with those people who are rising up against this government in other places as well. This is an international fight. We need an international solidarity movement for socialism. Really, we need a revolution, because we can't trust these police, these cops, these capitalists any longer with any kind of power at all. Their power needs to be taken away. And I have complete faith that the people here today, the people all over the world, that we can run this society democratically. And that's what we need to be fighting for. I hope y'all check it out. I got a couple copies of Left Voice, and I wanted to get some people's information about organizing for cops out of our unions, one, and for a strike against police terrorism. We can build that. We can do that. Do it in other countries. We can do that here. Thank you so much, Mom, for having me speak. Que viva la revolución.